Alright, hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are doing a first impression video. I love watching these. I'm gonna move my phone out of the way, it's right in my way. So, I've done a little bit of shopping and I have quite a bit of new stuff here that I would like to try. So, subscribe to my channel before you leave. And hit my notification bell so you know I upload every single Tuesday, Thursday, possibly Monday, Wednesday. I don't know, I'll keep you guys updated. And let's go ahead and get into the video. I have quite a bit of options here, which I think I might share with you what the different options are. Because whenever I see a first impression video and they're like, oh, I have several different options, I'm just gonna go with this one. I like to know what the other options are. I don't know, I guess I'm just nosy. Some of the things I don't have multiples of, but a lot of things I do. Like I have three different foundations, like four different concealers, I think, that I can try. So I'd like to give you guys an idea of what I have. That way if you guys want to see anything specific, you guys can leave like a request down below. But I'm not gonna be showing you guys anything that I have shown on my channel. So the things I got for Christmas that I haven't used yet, they're not going to be included in this video, except for the lip product, possibly. Depends on if I do end up using those as lip products or not. I'm trying to get everything sorted here because we have quite a bit of stuff to go through. So looking here, we have three different foundations, four concealers, two different loose powders, one pressed powder, three different blushes, two highlighters, two different eyeshadow palettes, possibly three different lips, depending on the look we do. So we got quite a bit of stuff here. So I can get this open. I would gladly start. Okay. So we only have one primer. Let me zoom you in just a little bit. We only have one primer that's new. And that is the Milani Prime Perfection Face Primer. This is the hydrating one. This feels like half empty. I don't know. So let's just squeeze it out here. It has like the consistency of like a lotion. It has like a slight scent to it. I think I got way too much. Yeah, definitely has a smell. Like I can smell it a lot more now that it's my face. It almost feels like glue a little bit on my face. It's not super sticky like glue. It's just thick and pasty like glue, if that makes any sense. So that is on. Let me get a mirror out here just so I can see. My skin does definitely feel a little bit more hydrated. It doesn't look super dry. I don't know how foundation is obviously going to sit on it. And typically I don't like mixing new foundations, concealers, and primers, but since I'm not going anywhere, I don't really care. But I'll definitely keep experimenting with this. I do like the way it feels on my skin. It absorbed really, really fast. And I feel definitely more refreshed, even though when it was going on, it was pretty thick. It doesn't feel thick once it's dried down. So I do like this. It says, prime skin to create a smooth canvas for makeup. I agree, hydrates and creates a natural finish. I definitely think it's a natural finish, and then reduces redness and minimizes the look of pores, lightweight, non-greasy feel. So I agree with all of that. Let's bring it in, it's oil free. So that is amazing. Okay, so I kind of want to start with the face first and then do the eyes, but something's telling me I should probably do the eyes first because I don't actually know if it's going to have fallout. So the only new eyeshadow base I have is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Eyeshadow Primer. I got this because I know it's really annoying that I only use like the same two because I only have two. So I decided to get a, try another one. So let's put this on real quick. I've never even swatched this. Okay, I was expecting it to be white, but it's like a tan color. Let's just pop it on and see how I like it with the brush. The same brush I normally use. Let's see do I think of it? I think there's a hair in my eye. Okay, so this definitely is going to be a product that needs to be blended out with the finger and not the brush. The brush is too, I almost want to say stiff, but the brush actually itself is a stiff, but I think the primer is just too thick for the brush. I don't think I've seen anybody use this primer. A lot of this stuff is drugstore. I think majority of it's drugstore actually, which is pretty awesome. Okay, so that primer went on nice and smooth. It's not creasing in any weird places, at least not yet. So I'll definitely keep you updated on this as well. It's pretty affordable, which is nice. And it's I like it so far. So we have two different eyeshadow palettes here, one drugstore, one high end. So the first one is the Hard Candy THC. Hard Candy, okay, Smoke Out. It's THC and CBD free. So it's called Smoke Out. It is this gorgeous green looking palette. It's very, very green. I also have the Anastasia Omrizi palette, which is brand spanking new. Like, I just got it today. And it is stunning. Anastasia, it's one of my favorite shadows ever. And I just swung the brush. I love the brushes as well, but this palette looks beautiful. I really like the look of Carly Bible's palette as well, but I did not pick that one up. I might next time I get my paycheck because it's beautiful too. But I personally want to use Omrizi, but I should probably use the Hard Candy one because I've had that one a little bit longer. We're gonna use a Hard Candy one for now, and then we'll come back and do a different video and maybe use the Omrizi palette because it is absolutely gorgeous. But I have had the Hard Candy one for like a week and I haven't really been feeling up to filming, so I haven't used it. So we're gonna go in with this one. So let's zoom in a little, that's the wrong way. We're gonna zoom in just a little bit here. I have no idea what look we're going for. So I'm gonna first go in with the shade Hash, I think, which is this one right here. I think I'm gonna use that as my transition color. I've used Hard Candy palettes in the past and I liked one of them. I didn't really care for the second one. So that's another reason why I kind of wanted to use this one, because I love Anastasia palettes. And plus, let's just keep it majority drugstore, shall we? So I like that color quite a lot, actually. Should I go in with the green? Might as well, I mean, why not? So let's go in grass, that's this one right here. And let's put that on top. I don't know, I'm just kind of playing in colors. It's a really light green. Yeah. So that kind of just made a smidge darker and have a bit more of a green hue to it, which I'm okay with because this palette is very, very green. So that might actually tie something in. I don't know what color scheme I'm going for, what look. I'm just kind of picking up colors and placing them and hoping that it looks okay. Alrighty, so let's go in with a little bit more of a detailed brush. Maybe a little smidgen more dense. I don't want something like super, super dense. This should be fine. And let's take Stoned, which is this one right here. And let's put that in my crease just to test it out. These mattes are really, really pretty. Definitely a step up from the last Hard Candy palette I tried. I wasn't a huge fan of the mattes in that palette. But these are really, really nice. Then again, that was like 2-3 years ago. It's been a while. So they could have easily reformulated. It could have just been that palette that I didn't really like. But I did try another one of their palettes I don't have anymore, just because I had like the same exact colors in other palettes that I used more. But I really, really liked that palette, so. Pulling here. That's really pretty. And they're blending out beautifully. I don't exactly know what color I want to put on my lid. I kind of want to use like this one right here. It's like a green and has like gold dots in it. Like I think that would look really pretty. That color is called Hazed and it's really pretty. I don't know if you guys can see it on camera, but it's like gold and it almost like marbled with like green and I don't know. It's really pretty. So I'm gonna try that one and see what I think of it. Marbled shadows like this sometimes I'm not a huge fan of. This one's really pretty. It's definitely like a light green, but it has little flecks of gold in it. It's definitely really, really pretty. I don't know if you guys can really see how pretty it actually is on camera, but it is really, really pretty. I like it. I like it. Definitely a lot prettier than I was anticipating the color to be. These two look like pressed glitters. I don't actually think I'm going to use them today, but they look really interesting. Let's go with this dark green. It's called Baked, which is this one right here. It's like the darkest matte in the palette. Let's put that on my outer edge. That's a really pretty dark green. These are really, really pretty. This would be an amazing palette for anybody who loves green. I love green shadows. Which is probably what drew me to the palette in the first place, but this is really, really pretty. And there's all kinds of different finishes in here. And I obviously haven't tried them all, but the shades that I have tried are amazing. And they're blending out beautifully on this primer and everything. Which, maybe it's the primer, I don't know. But the primer seems to be doing a really good job at making them very opaque. And they're sticking pretty nicely. My next video I film, I might use that primer again. And I'll keep using it until I figure out if it's like the best thing ever because it was pretty affordable. I'm really excited about this foundation though. All right, so we're just going to go back in with that lid color and pack some more on since a lot of it did get blended away. So now I have basically one new eyeliner but in three different colors, so three different eyeliners. These are the NYX Epic Wear Waterproof Eye and Body Liquid Liner. These are the three that I picked up of this liner. I think I might try the red one. I don't know if lilac or yellow would look right. I don't even know if the red's gonna look right, but I really wanna try it. So I'm gonna try the red one and hope for the best. You guys know I'm not the best with liquid eyeliner. Bristle's a little stiff on this one, a little pointy, so it hurts just a little bit. When I swatched it earlier, I noticed that. I think that looks pretty cool. I mean, it's about what I was expecting. I think that's pretty. They're not even, like at all, but it's really, really pretty, and I think it would be, once I trim that hard tip off, I think it would be really, really pretty. It looks like Christmas, but I think it would be really, really pretty for just like a pop of color. It's still pretty wearable, so it's not like super, super obvious that you're wearing a colored eyeliner, which I like. I did get some up here though. Foundation now. I have three different foundations. The first one is the Too Faced Born This Way foundation. This is in the shade Swan. I think I'm the last person on the planet to try this, I'm really excited about this. I'm actually really excited about all three of these. Then I have the Beauty Bakery Instabake Aqua Glass Foundation in the shade 357WN. And then lastly, I have the shade, or the foundation, this is Burt's Bees Goodness Glows in the shade Porcelain 1005. This is the one I've had the longest. I got these two earlier today. I'm really excited about both of these, but I think I might actually try the Burt's Bees one today. So I'm gonna shake it up. I hope that I like this. It's a lot thicker than I was expecting. Not necessarily a bad thing. This might be a smidgen too cool. Oh my God. This foundation smells terrible. This might be a smidgen too cool, but I feel like once I have powder on and stuff, I think it might work. Yeah, this foundation is a very awful scent. Oh. It almost smells like egg. Got really pretty coverage, but my sponge isn't really wanting to blend it out, I see. This is not a foundation that I'm instantly in love with. It's sitting kind of funny on my face, which could be the primer, but I cannot get over the smell. Like, it just, it stinks. I've never smelt a foundation that smells this bad. Like, this is foul. I mean, once you start blending it out, the smell definitely goes away, but because I keep pumping more out of the bottle, it keeps coming back. So if you are sensitive to smell, this may not be the one for you. I definitely think that right now it's a smidgen too light. I think the next shade up was way too dark, if I remember correctly. So hopefully after we get powder on and everything, it evens out a little bit. Review on the Burt's Bees foundation. It definitely, now that it's set, is sitting a lot better on my skin. It has decent coverage. The smell is terrible. But I don't know, it's kind of like that foundation that I'm not extremely in love with, but I don't hate. Like, it's just kind of like, okay, it's nice, but that's all I would really say about it. It's decent. Okay, so concealers, we have four of them. We have the e.l.f. 16 hour camo concealer in the shade Fair Warm. We have the Beauty Bakery Instabake 3-in-1 Concealer in the shade Frappe Hour. Then we have the L'Oreal Infallible Full Wear Concealer in the shade Porcelain. And then we have the CoverGirl True Blend Undercover Concealer in the shade Fair Porcelain. I'll wait to try the Beauty Bakery one, though. I can try it with the Beauty Bakery foundation. Let's see. We have CoverGirl. What concealer? Let's try the e.l.f. one. Let's try the e.l.f. one. This is the e.l.f. 16 hour camo concealer in the shade Fair Warm. I haven't even swatched these. This is a huge doe foot applicator. Nice consistency. I like the consistency. It's pretty nice. Oh wow, this has really good coverage. That has really good coverage, especially for the price. I put way too much on. This is a foundation or concealer where very little goes a very long way. I didn't even dip back in. Okay, so I like that concealer. I put way too much on, so ignore my very white under eyes. But it has very nice coverage. It is settling into my fine lines, but like basically every concealer with my NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop does that. So that's pretty normal, but the coverage is incredible. And I'm so fair that it's really, really hard to find a concealer that brightens. This one did it, so pretty impressed. So I have one pressed powder, which is the CoverGirl True Blend in the shade Translucent Fair, which I might use to set my concealer. Actually, I'm gonna use this set my concealer. Let's use this to set the concealer, and then we'll use one of the other two to set the face. So let's just... It doesn't seem to be darkening the concealer, which is nice. And if it is, maybe it is just a hair. Yeah, I think it is just a hair, because look at that. But it's still definitely a lot brighter than normal. You're doing a pretty good job of setting it. Doesn't seem to look super cakey. I mean, you can definitely tell that I need to moisturize because right here is really dry, and that's not, you know, the product's fault. That's my fault because I didn't moisturize my skin today. Oops. Sorry, I'm like right up in the mirror because I want to see what it looks like, but it looks pretty good. I mean, it is dry right here, but that again is my fault. But the powder itself seemed to set it really, really nicely. I like that. I like this. Then I have two loose powders. The first one I have here is the Physicians Formula Mineral Wear in the shade Translucent Light. Then I have the Revlon Photo Ready Candid Anti-Pollution Setting Powder in the shade 001. All right, let's try the Neutrogena one. I don't have a lot of Neutrogena stuff. So this, like I said, is the Mineral Wear Loose Powder. It has SPF 16 in it, so I would not recommend this for photography. I don't know if this is actually going to be translucent, but it says that it is. So let's hope that it's right. And we'll just take some on a big powder brush. And set that foundation down. The lid, not ideal at all. It's way too small. And the powder goes everywhere because you have to knock it into the lid to get it out. So very, very messy. So if you don't want to make a mess, this is probably not the right product for you. But it seemed to set my foundation pretty well. I think it made it match a lot better. I don't see it really cleaning up anywhere that I wouldn't expect it to. Other, you know, my dry patches, that's expected. So I think I like this. I think I'm gonna keep trying it out because it doesn't seem super cakey. I don't think I have anything new to contour with. I do have a new bronzer, but this is like, I'm gonna have to bronze with that. So let's just quickly contour with something. We're gonna use this guy. This is the Makeup Revolution Bronze and Glow Duo. We're just gonna use that side to contour since I don't have anything new. Bronzer, like actual bronzer, I have the Maybelline City Bronzer in the shade 100. This is too light for me to contour, I think, which is why I'm gonna use it to bronze instead. Oh yeah, that'd be way too warm for me to bronze. I'm glad I didn't do that. bronzer. It's a really pretty color. It's matte. It's a really, really pretty color. Yeah, I like this bronzer. It's really, really pretty. This was a success. I like this. Okay, so blushes. I have three different blushes here. I have one by Revlon. This is a Revlon powder blush in the shade Rosy Rendezvous. It's a beautiful color. Then I have two by Burt's Bees. This one is in Toasted Cinnamon, which I love this color. And then the last one here is Shy Pink, which looks like this. I might go with Toasted Cinnamon because it's unlike anything I've ever actually worn before. That's really pretty. I wasn't expecting to like this color as much as I do. It's different than like every blush I have, but in like the best way possible. So I'm a big fan of Toasted Cinnamon. Let's set my face really quick. I don't have anything new to set my face with, so I'm just going to use the Moral Norman Expert Touch Finishing Spray. This is one of my favorites. I have a lot of powder on my face right now, a lot of new products, so I don't know how they're gonna mix together. In some places, my skin's looking a little bit more dry than normal, but that's to be expected, especially because I'm using completely new products. I didn't moisturize today, which was my bad, I forgot. It's to be expected. But I mean, overall my skin really doesn't look that bad. I mean, there is some dry patches that have powder clinging to them, but that literally always happens to have dry skin. So that's nothing against the products, but so far I've really liked everything that we've tried so far. And I have two highlighters here. I have one by e.l.f. This is the e.l.f. I think it's just metallic highlighter in the shade White Gold. It is absolutely stunning. And then I have this one, it's Juvia's Place, a highlighter. This is this Tribe Highlighter Volume 3. And it is absolutely beautiful. But I think I'm gonna try the e.l.f. one today. We'll try the Juvia's one's place in another video. But I really wanna try this e.l.f. one. Like, it looks really nice. I don't think I've tried an e.l.f. highlighter, and if I have, it's been a really, really, really long time. So I'm gonna clean off my highlighter brush. And we're gonna go ahead and go in and hope that I like it. It's not too dark. Okay, it's pretty. It's definitely not as intense as I was expecting it to be. Like, I was expecting it to be really, really metallic, and it's not. But it definitely is nice for like a kind of subtle glow. I've laid it on, so it's really, really pretty. But it's definitely a lot lighter than I was anticipating it would be, which I'm kind of bummed about. But it is pretty. It's just not as intense as I wished, but not every single day I want an intense highlighter, so this could actually be a good thing for me. Because a lot of my highlighters are really, really intense, and I have one that's like barely there. This is like a nice in between. It's not clinging to any of my texture because it's like finely milled or something. Like, it's just beautiful. My under eyes are not looking the greatest right now. I'll admit to that. But this e.l.f. highlighter, it's okay. I don't hate it, but I'm not totally in love with it. And let's zoom you back in to finish the under eyes. So I'm first gonna go in with the shade Stoned, which is that one. And I'll put that underneath my lower lash line. Then I'm going to go in with the shade Hash, which is this one right here. I'm gonna use that to blend that out. Okay, now that I have shadow down there, my under eyes look a lot better. All right, so let's take the shade Blazed, which is this one right here, and highlight my inner corner. Hopefully it's light enough. Oh yeah. It's really pretty. The Maybelline Total Temptation Mascara. I don't have any new ones open. I'm trying to use up the ones I have. Okay, so for lips, I have these two things from Aimé. They are Color and Care Lip Oil and Stick. This one is in the shade Rosy Glaze, and then this one is Dolce de Leche. But I also have a ton of these. These are the NYX Slip Tease Full Color Lip Lacquers. I have tried these before, so I almost want to try the Aimé one. But Caitlin picked this color out, and it's green. But I might go in with this one. So I'm gonna use Dolce de Leche. It's like a lip oil. I think it's not what we are looking for today. It is really, really pretty and like comfortable on lips though. So if you're looking for something like that, that would be an amazing option. However, I want something with a little bit more color today. Just a smidge. So Caitlin picked out this dark green. I don't really want to wear dark green. So I'm gonna line my lips with the NYX Pale Pink Lip Liner Pencil. Then we're gonna go in with the NYX Slip Tease in the shade Undercover Babe. I haven't tried this color. Alrighty, one, and that is it for this first impression video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel before you leave. Hit my notification bell so you know when I upload my videos. Give this video a big thumbs up, and I'll see you in my next video.